we've been studying how that God has planned for you and I, amen, to be conformed and transformed into the same image as Christ, with His Spirit flowing through you and I, amen, that we can do the same work that He did. Oh, you don't hear me. I told the class on Wednesday night, you know, it talks about Ezekiel 37, I believe that's where it is, talking about, amen, the vision that Ezekiel had. And first of all, he went down by the river and he waded out in the water, and the water was up to his ankle.
Amen.
Talking about the Spirit of God. And then also, amen, he had a vision that the water was up to his knee.
Yes.
And then the water was up to his waist.
Hallelujah.
Amen. And then after that, the water was up to his shoulder.
Yes.
Amen. And then after that, the water was so deep that he had to swim. Talking about the level of the Spirit of God working in the church and in our lives.
Hallelujah.
We've been waiting. We've been waiting around in water just up for our ankles to be locked. It's time, amen, when we walk through those doors, it's time for us to dive in. Get in with the flow and what God's doing. Quit looking around and sizing each other up. Amen. And let God have His way in our midst.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Amen. The biggest hindrance in walking in the Spirit, and that is our own living environment.
Yes.
You know, where we live and where we work and who we hang out with, if we're not careful, some of that doubt and fear and contamination will rub off on us. Instead of us being, you and I, making a difference, amen, being the light of the world, amen, our spirit gets dampened because of who we're around. My friend, can I just tell you, with the help of God, it should be the other way, Mr. McLeod. Hallelujah. Amen. When we walk into a room, we walk into the store, a world we find ourselves walking, amen, we should make a difference. They must see the anointing upon our lives. Amen. There's something different about that individual. They must be a child of God. We're going to study, haven't went over this yet, the supernatural eyesight. In other words, how, amen, how our hope is a link, a vital link, that works together with faith to reach out and receive our miracle.
Amen.
Amen. We're going to see how, amen, your circumstances and my circumstances, amen, as miracle, they are as miracle opportunities. Come on, somebody.
Yeah,
we're getting over our head. They're going to be miracle opportunity. Amen. And we have to live in a daily expectancy to expect a miracle.
Hallelujah.
There's nothing wrong, amen, for telling our story, as Sister Davis said earlier. Amen. But that's a different in murmuring and complaining about our situation. Hallelujah. We may say it like this. I don't understand why God has got me going through the valley. I don't understand the circumstances, but I know. I know God is going to intervene no matter what it is. If you're looking for work, if you're looking for anything, if you're a child of God, God is going to be going to be over and above and beyond. Hallelujah. 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 Oh, I'm going to get radical here now. I heard a preacher say yesterday over the radio, he's sick and tired of folks coming in and Christian believers talking about, I can't find no job. I can't find no work. I can't do this. I can't do that. Oh, I'm going to tell you, my friend, you're not standing on the Word. The Word says God supply all of your needs according to His riches in glory. Amen. God said, I can do all things through Christ Jesus, which strengthens me. Amen. God I'm coming down to the end here. But we got to set the Lord's table. It's time for the church, and I'll bring it down, the Silver Spring Church of God, to do more than just talk about God's miracle power.
All right, yes.
I can talk about Silver Spring because I'm part of the family. You that have family, you know what I'm talking about. We love each other. Amen. But we don't mind holding back what we think.
All right, say it, Pastor.
Amen. The time is stop talking. And go to walk.
Yeah.
Come on, everybody. Warming the pew. And go outside of these four walls and be used of God in a special way.
Yeah.
In other words, what I'm trying to say is, it's time to practice what we preach.
Yeah.
Hallelujah. Yeah. You see, if we believe Christ promises that He will do the same work as He did, or we will do the same work as He did, we must act in faith and begin to do the same work. What do you mean, Pastor? I'm saying that God can anoint you and I. And He will anoint us. We have that desire, that hunger, that thirst. And we can go around and lay hands upon the sick. And they shall recover. Come on, somebody. We can lay hands upon those that are demonized. That means the demons will be cast out. Amen. We, amen, praise God, can lay hands and tell them where hope is. Come on, somebody.
Yes, yes. Hallelujah.
You see, instead of being afraid to boldly proclaim God's miracle power as being real today, I don't believe I'm preaching to a Pentecostal church. Talking about being afraid.
Say,
when I grew up, we wasn't afraid of nothing. You and he preached this, they would think, well, why'd he preaching that to us? You know, because they believed in everything.
Uh-huh.
Their faith was, I can tell you stories after stories of a boy, amen, sitting on the front row because I had to. My parents required me to be there.
That's right.
And seeing the miracle power at work.
Yes.
Good.
Seeing it work. And that was just the norm in that church.
Yes. Amen. Yes.
I remember we had old red potbelly stove. You know, it was red hot. The pipe was hot. And the power of God hit. And the saints of God were shouting around there and being slain in the spirit. We had a man by the name of, I can't get it right now, but I can picture him in my mind. Amen. He'd get the spirit begin to move on him. He'd start real. He would start real slow. Amen. When he starts slow shaking just a little bit, you can everybody start clearing away. Uh-oh. This man is under the anointing of the Spirit of God. Amen. And what happened was, amen, he got to shaking and he got to kicking, and God was dealing with him in such a measure until he bumped up to the stove that was hot. And the pipe was red hot. The pipe fell over. Amen. This man picked that pipe red hot up, put it back on the stove, and put it back in the seat. I'm sitting there. And he kept on shouting. I go on and on and on and on and on and on. Hallelujah. Praise God. I can remember my dad talking about up in the country. He was a tent preacher. He was going to preach a tent meeting, and it had a flat tire in the middle of nowhere. I think he had some folks with him.
Jesus.
And they looked in the trunk, and they had the tire, spare tire there, but they didn't have a jack.
Oh,
he said they just joined hands together.
Yes,
said, God, through your power, give us supernatural strength that we can lift this car and put this tire on this car. You know, God gave them the strength to do that. I'm sick and tired of telling stories from the past.
Yes.
I want to let you know that God is the same yesterday, today, and tomorrow.